G'day guys, Tilswenny here and welcome back to Marble Mountain. A couple of weeks ago, I did a live stream where I began work on the aviation club that sits out in the desert, just outside of Tumbleweed. It was super fun, it was a really, really fun live stream. We didn't really make a huge amount of progress, to be honest, never really do, but it was fun nonetheless. And today's episode, I'm going to finish off the work that I started, detailing this bad boy up and doing some much needed terraforming and finishing up around this area because I've been sort of neglecting it for a while and been wanting to get to it. And I also create this really cool boneyard with all these like abandoned and broken down planes, which you'll see me work on in just a little bit. I really think this turned out great. I think it fits the scene. It's a little bit out of place, I have to be honest. I don't know how realistic it is. but look, we're going for like mild realism in Marble Mountain. It's sort of like the hierarchy is I want things to look interesting and fun and cool, and then I might think about realism, to be honest. Because I just think that something like this really paints a really great picture, you know, having these abandoned boneyard planes that just sit out in the desert like this, and especially when they're like the first thing you see when you cross the bridge, go over the swampland, make your way into the desert, and then you just get greeted with these planes along the highway, which I think look great. They're just probably a little bit big, but I don't care. I'm going to keep them there regardless. And thanks everybody who joined the live stream. Thanks everybody who's been joining the live stream. I've been streaming to about 650 people on average, which has been nuts. I don't know what is going on. I don't know where all these people are coming from, but appreciate it. It's great. I really do enjoy it. And if you ever want to catch any of my live streams, I stream at about 8 a.m. Sunday morning Australian Sydney time, which is about midday in America, and at night, like 9 p.m. to about 1 a.m. if you're in Europe. Sorry, Europeans. It's generally the best time I can do it, unless I want to stream at like 4 a.m., which I'm not that willing to do just yet. Maybe, I don't know, we'll see how it goes. I'm not going to do 4 a.m. streams. But that's generally like the best time for me to really stream and get the most amount of people there, which is kind of what's happening, which is really, really fun. We end up making a lot of big decisions in those streams, which is, probably the benefit of watching them, which is what we did in the last stream. Not the last stream, but this one where we placed down the aviation club. We figured out exactly where we wanted it. And basically, you guys came up with the idea of creating a boneyard as well and also extending out the runway quite a little bit, which is what I did. So basically, to extend out the runway, I didn't want to do it too large, so it's probably a bit unrealistic, but I wanted to extend it out just a touch because it was just a little bit too short. I'm glad I did. But the reason why I didn't want to do it too much bigger is then it would just look a bit out of place in the desert. So I need to find that balance between something that's somewhat realistic and also matches the other aspects of this area. Don't want to make it too large. But I just extended it out using a mod, which is the custom runway mod or something like that. I can't remember exactly what it's called. But basically, it doesn't mean that the plane will use all that runway, it just extends it out a little bit. And I will end up using that mod when I do create the actual proper airport for Marble Mountain. This one's just like a little regional one. So my idea, so basically the aviation club is for people who want to, fly as a hobby, but I would think that this airport out this way would be serving as a domestic airport. And I would say, and I know that's, it's not a big distance, but I would say that people who want to fly to Montana would fly from this airport. We will have a couple more of these sort of airports around Marble Mountain. And by the way, let me know what you think, because I think it'd be kind of cool to sort of imagine that there were regional airports throughout this map. We do have to it might take, in terms of City Skylines time, but it might take a minute to drive from here to Montana. But I like to imagine that in this universe of Marble Mountain, it would probably take 6-7 hours. So, you have to sort of use your imagination a little bit in terms of the scale of this project. But I think that's just the beauty of it. So in terms of detail, there's not a huge amount I could really do because airports generally have not much going on around the actual runways. So I am instead just trying to bring out a little bit more of the ground color by just very lightly changing the ground texture using the resources mods, which basically allows me to change the ground texture. So I'm just trying to get a bit of green out because you know, there's quite a lot of shrubs around these sort of runways and airports, at least the ones that I'm sort of getting inspiration from, looking around California, looked around these sort of deserty areas, found this really cool one called 29 Palms or whatever it is, and I thought that was like pretty close to my name, so decided to take inspiration from that one, which is a pretty unusual looking airport, to be honest. Like, actually pretty much in the, like, nestled in the mountainside, which is really strange. And yeah, I mean, there's a lot of shrubs around these airports, so I sort of thought that would be a good excuse to use a whole bunch. So I'm just using a bunch of props, which are pretty heavy, but you know, I think that's fine because there's not a huge amount going on around this area, and I did want this area to look pretty detailed. And now I'm starting to work on the boneyard. So this is, again, unrealistic. I know that. It's unrealistic because I don't know why they'd have like such massive planes in like a regional airport like this. So who knows? Maybe someone's collecting these, or maybe there's a reason why there are, like, who knows? I don't know what the reason is why there's such big planes and why there are so many of them in this area, but damn it, they look cool. So I'm just sticking with them, alright? Especially that big broken one that's laying on its side. I mean, they're all laying on its side, but the one on an angle. And I think that's like such a great opener for when you enter into the desert. And they just make for such great cinematics, which you'll see at the very end, some really great cinematics of what it's like when you're like down nice and close and when you can see these, you know, from a distance. I think they really add to the whole region. And I just wanted to, you know, create a couple of piles of different plane parts and using some decals just to rough up the surface a little bit. And again, using some of the prop, I keep on forgetting what these are called, but they're basically props and they came with the Park Life DLC, and I use them all the time because they're really quite detailed and they allow you to create some really nice overgrown areas, which is what I'm doing. And it's funny because I remember when Fresh Popcorn created a boneyard many years ago for Arrowhead Junction, and yeah, I only just used the Arrowhead Junction train station, so who knows, maybe I'll pull out a couple more of those moves from that series, but you know, we'll see how we go. But ever since he created that boneyard, I was like, I really want to do one too, and I haven't done one before, so you know, finally got around to doing it. And to my surprise, there weren't a huge amount of boneyards I could find on Google Earth. Unless you guys can find some for me and leave the link in the description, that would be, you know, awesome if you could, but I couldn't really find any ones to get ideas from. The only one I could find was the Mojave Airport, which was in California, same sort of area that I was taking ideas from. So I mean, that did serve as a good inspiration for this build, but mine was fairly different, and you know, mine being a very regional airport definitely is not going international. Look, unless we build a border somewhere, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Good. Might be interesting, but let's not go off track. I couldn't really find anything that was, you know, had the same sort of effect with such a small airport. So you know, that does give me an idea that, you know, maybe an airport so small wouldn't really justify having a boneyard like this. But once again, I'm not really too concerned about that. I'm more concerned about the effect that it has around this area, and I think it's probably worthwhile having something like this in this location. Some of the other things I've been up to is I've been placing down some of the Marble Mountain signs, some of the billboards that were created by you guys. They look awesome in this area, and the really cool thing is I placed down a billboard up on that cliffside rocky mountain thing, and it's really cool because that's for a diner that's in Chinchilla, which is a town that's just down the road, and it's like advertising that diner, and then you can actually go to that diner, which is kind of I think, a nice little bit of extra detail. And now I'm starting to work on the terraforming in this area. So this is something I've been putting off for a while because I knew that it would be a pretty big job, and it was a big job, and there was only so much I could really leave in the time lapse. So you will see like a couple of jump shots. Sounds like a basketball term. I can't think of the terms I'm trying to say. But basically, I wanted to build a bunch of this, and I just didn't think that a lot of it would make the time lapse. But that's fine. I'm glad I did work on this area because it was definitely something that I needed to get done. But I have left a lot of it open because I do want to get some suggestions from you guys. What sort of stuff do you think I should start placing down in this desert? I know a lot of you guys are suggesting Area 51, and you probably expect me to say, no, I'm not going to do that, but I am. I totally am. But not for a while, and I don't know exactly where. So if you have any ideas, just hit me up, but I think it'd be pretty cool somewhere nice and secret. And you know, I do want to keep this area somewhat bare. I don't want to go overboard with like building lots and lots of towns. Like, it's already getting kind of full. But I do want to add little secret little areas like here and there. You know, those little gems you find out in the desert. I feel like the weirdest stuff always like turns out in the desert. So, you know, it would be kind of fun to do little interesting things like that around here. So let me know in the comments if you have any suggestions, and we'll work on that potentially in a live stream, because I think it would be fun to do something like that in a live stream. But you can see me working on mostly the road networks, and I changed it up a little bit because I felt like there were too many main roads, whereas I wanted there just to be the one main road. So we do have like two highways. And then we have this more national road, which is the one that I'm working on at the moment. And I wanted this to be a little bit more out in the sticks, like you'd only take this if you're going to a really specific location. Whereas those highways take you to more of the general areas. So I tried to get rid of what I did. I got rid of a lot of those other roads that were just sort of snaking around. But I have left a lot of dirt roads because out in the desert, there's just like huge amounts of dirt roads just snaking all over the place. A lot of crazy grids out in California. It's pretty nuts. I know the story of California City. That's a pretty interesting project, which I do a little bit of stuff based on that in a little later on in this time lapse. But yeah, that is a very, very interesting story, which I highly suggest you go and check it out. But basically, they plan to build like an entire city out this way, and they mapped out all the road networks, and then nothing really eventuated. So that was pretty interesting. I did like a little bit like that. I extended out Tumbleweed a little bit, as if there was more planned development in that area, but never eventuated. That'll be a little bit later on in this time lapse, but I kind of just wanted to do some dirt roads just like snaking out because there are a whole bunch. But again, just wanted to leave a bunch of it open too. Now I'm working on this interchange. I wanted to keep this pretty low key, so nothing too nuts going on here. Just making sure that the clearance for the train as well is okay, because I know that really bugs you guys if I have anything that's clipping. The last episode of Marble Mountain, there was a bit of clipping going on, but don't worry, that got fixed up pretty easily. And yeah, I didn't really want to do too much in terms of this interchange, so nothing too crash hot. And I also want to keep it fairly small, because you know, basically, if you make things too big in this series, then everything starts to go a little bit out of proportion, whereas I want this desert to feel really big, like a really, really sparse and big desert. And now, I'm starting to work on some of the hillsides that are going to sit around here. So, California has some really amazing mountain hillsides and valleys within the desert area, and I wanted to try and recreate some of these areas. I was really struggling with like getting the texture right on these mountains, because the actual color of these sort of mountains are, you know, really diverse, and you know, you get like lots of pinks and these like really dark brown colors, and I couldn't really create any sort of colors besides the ones that are really in my texture pack, which is a bit tricky to use. I think I get the colors somewhat all right, but I really wish I could, you know, get some different sort of things going on. I know a lot of you guys are probably like, $2, why don't you use the theme texture or theme mixer mod? But you know what? No, I'm trying not to use too many. It's funny because I get such divided comments. I get people saying, download more mods, download these assets, download this, download that. And then I get people going like, oh, didn't he say he was going to only do vanilla assets and now he doesn't? This guy uses cheats and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, you guys are very divided. Let me just say that. I can't win. But my rule of thumb is if I can't do it without using extra mods or using extra assets, then I grab some extra mods and assets. With that being said, I don't want to use theme mixer mod because then I just think it adds that extra layer of difficulty when it comes to sharing the save game, which I do with my patrons, and I don't really, I think it's hard enough, you know, downloading save games, and I don't really want to add anything extra. But I'm pretty happy with how this valley, these little mountains turn out. This whole desert is actually very mountainous and very hilly, and I don't mind that because when I do go down to like street view, it sort of makes everything look a little bit different. Like it feels like you're changing environments and makes the whole area feel much larger than it really is. Whereas if I just had it all flat and plain, then I don't think it'd have the same effect. I'm pretty excited to do some driving videos out this way, which I haven't recorded for a while, so I might have to get back into that. Be cool to do one, like doing a whole journey out this way from Montana. I think that would be pretty awesome. But guys, that is pretty much it for today's episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed it, don't forget to leave me some feedback or by rating up the video. That helps me out heaps. Before I go, I want to give a special shout out to some of my patrons like Daniel Yates, KBN, and Mike Wagner. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Much appreciated, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!